Well, hello you ibbly bibbly bobblers, and welcome to yet another episode of One Credit Champ, the most popular gaming show on YouTube.
Sorry, what's that?
The 97,009th most popular gaming show on YouTube.
What are we playing today? Today's game is Change Airblade, so let's put the credit in, let's press start, and let's choose our aeroplane. And we've got 8 to choose from. There's Blaster, there's Alpha Blade, that's Stone Golem, there's Sylph, the next one is... that's Omega Arrow, that's Galleria, but I think we're going to choose Alpha Blade, because it's red. And everybody knows all the best shoot-em-up ships are red. They are. It's like common knowledge and shit. And we are up against the F-36X Zero, apparently the pilot of which likes long walks on the beach and the smooth jazz of Kenny G. But fuck him. This is Change Airblade, made in 1999 by Sammy, and the answer to that age-old question that nobody ever had. What if a bullet-hell shmup did the horizontal boogaloo with a versus fighter? Yeah, this is essentially a one-on-one shmup. The bottom player plays the game relatively normally, but if you're up top, you get a super bar that allows you to shoot pretty dom-mockle patterns, or when it's all the way full, allows you to dock into a proper boss ship like he did there. But it didn't help him, because now he's dead, and we'll never hear that sweet saxophony ever, ever again. No, he won't. Anyway, off to our next opponent, and our next opponent is... the XF-48J Gelda, the pilot of which likes long walks on the beach and the slow, torturous death of his enemies, probably by subjecting them to the smooth jazz of Kenny G. Anyway, back to the game. You have 3 health bars. They work like lives. When you're down bottom, often one hit will be instant death, whilst if you're up top, it's whittled away, and now I am the granddad, and he's already dead. I didn't even get the chance of being in the big plane. That's a shame. That's a real shame, because getting the switcheroo pickup in one player mode is as fucking rare as hen's teeth. Never mind, off we go again to our next matchup, and our next opponent is... the pilot of which likes... pudding. Now, while this is a fun and interesting concept as a single player title, it suffers from problems as a two-player game. The thing is, in a single-player bullet hell shooter, you know those games are programmed to be hard, but they'll be predictable. And if you know the bullet patterns, you can get past them. The problem here is that when you give somebody who's playing the boss the ability to spam crazy Death Blossom attacks as and when he pleases, you soon find that certain combinations of attacks are nigh on undodgeable for the poor old schmuck sitting in the bottom half of the screen. Even if he uses the temporary invulnerability he can get from bomb pickups. Bottom line, Change Airblade is as unbalanced as all fuck. You'll never see a game like this headlining an Evo, that's for certain. Which is kind of a shame, because something like this would stand out among the Street Fighters and Tekkens and Super Smash Buttocks. So there we go. The pudding boy is toast. You can go eat your flummery in hell now. In hell.
In hell.
Excuse me. Still got a bit of a cold, you know. Anyway, off we go, and we're up against our next opponent, the YF-222 Delta, Delta Edge. And the pilot here is a delusional grifter who found success running a software label in the 1980s, but when that particular business started hitting their skids, he became a trademark troll, demanding everybody pay him to use the name he supposedly owned. Until one day, his entire operation was sued out of existence. He lost all of his trademarks, and now he's a priest treating the terminally ill. Because we all know, the big money, it's in religion, right? That's where the big money is. People on deathbeds, looking for redemption. Seriously. Fucking disgusting. Opportunistic bullshit. Sickens me. Absolutely bloody sickens me. Anyway, see you next Tuesday, Timothy. See you next Tuesday. And with that unsightly sore on the arse of humanity out of the way, on to our next opponent, because I'm pretty sure nothing can be anywhere near as offensive as the the AH997 Cyclops. I'm not sure if I can say that without sounding really racist. The pilot here is not stereotypical in any way, and probably likes some things and not others and shit. It's alright, I think I got away with it. Now, where were we? Ah yes, time to get back on topic, and I know I've been avoiding a question here. Did this game have any home ports? Nope. No it didn't. Did it get any sequels? Nope. Shit out of luck there too, and it's a damn shame. Because as unbalanced as this game is, I can't deny that it isn't fun, and more importantly, original. A hybrid of two staple arcade genres, and with a little tweaking, maybe Sammy would have been onto something. But that's Sammy for you. So many of their arcade titles just end up falling into obscurity. Anyway, we're up against the XH10X Banshee in the pilot. Well, the pilot likes beef. We'll have beef with literally anything. And anything with beef. How would you like your coffee, Mr. Banshee, they say. And Banshee says, black, with beef. And I don't mean as a side dish here. No. I'm talking as a substitute to sugar. Diced Aberdeen Angus, bobbing up and down in his cup of Americano. takes all sorts, doesn't it? Look, even his boss machine is red. The colour of his favourite meat. He calls the ship the round tip of death. He'll shank you without a second thought. Oh dear. I seem to have made a mistake. I'll stop it now, I promise. Well, that will be game over for us. And it is time to make the bum entry. And where did we place? First, of course we did, because we're that damn awesome. And maybe because we're running the game default high scores. But let me keep this one victory, okay? Please? Unless you know how to jump 97,000 places on Social Blade. Until next time, bye-bye!